in order to implement direct mapping. So if you want to implement direct mapping in hardware, you can implement in this way. So this is a MUX, this is a cache, this is a comparator. So these are, you know, these devices I explained clearly in digital logic design. So even though if you don't know about these devices, just remember whenever a MUX contains 2 power n input lines, then n selection lines. Easy. This is a device. These are the inputs. 4 inputs. We have two selection lines. One output line. MUX is nothing but we are giving some selection lines, we are giving some control, we are going to that line and getting that an element and giving to the comparator. Okay, you got my point? Easy. So there is a cache. Is there? This is a multiplexer MUX, this is a comparator, this is a cache. As of now, whenever CPU generates an address, what we have to do, we have to go to, before accessing main memory, we have to go to cache memory and get the required word. Before accessing main memory, we have to access cache memory, right? And in direct mapping, we have tag, line number and word offset. Okay, leave about that, not required right now. So once we get address, we are getting the line number, right? By using line number, we have to go to the particular line in cache and compare the tag bits. If the tag bit is matching, then there is a cache hit. Otherwise, there is a cache miss. How to implement that one? Let us say CPU generated an address. CPU telling go to CPU line number 3 and match the tag bit 0. How to do that? Simple. You know this MUX, this is a comparator. Even though you don't know about MUX or comparator, I will explain this concept clearly in digital logic design. Right off now, just remember, MUX is nothing but whenever you are given some input, it will take and it will go to the correspondent line and get that word and submit to the comparator. Just simple. This is a device, we are giving some input, it is going to that particular input, we are giving some bit, it is going to particular line and getting an element and sending that to the comparator. That is MUX will do. It is saying we are giving 1 1, go to line number 3. Now MUX will take this 3 and go to, it will check. This is line number 0, line number 1, line number 2, line number 3. We are given 3, right? It will going to line number 3 and getting the element. Here one element is there. So this element, so MUX is getting this element and submitting to the comparator. Okay. Now tag. We have to compare tag bit, right? Now I am comparing tag bit with this 0. I am getting this 0, this bit through MUX. Now I have 0 bit and 0 bit. Now comparator will tell if they are same, it will give you 1. If they are not same, it give you 0. They are same, right? So it giving 1. There is a cache hit. If they are not same, then it will give cache, it will give 0. Then that is miss. Okay, simple. And always remember, MUX can only transfer 1 bit, 1 tag bit only. It cannot transfer 2 tag bits. It can transfer only 1 tag bit, 1 output only. It have only 1 bit MUX, 1 bit only it can transfer. And comparator, no problem. We have 3 bits, then 1 comparator, 3 bit comparator we can use. But MUX only we can use 1 bit only. I will tell you, if I have 3 bits, so what I have to do? Before, I will tell you, I will take another example. Just if CPU generates line number 01. So we are giving 01 to MUX. Now MUX taken 01 and checking which line. This is 00 line, 01, 1011. It is giving 01, right? It will go to this line because it is 01 line and this line and getting the element. What it is here, let us say here, this is the tag bit, tag part. So this part, for example, it contains around 1. This tag bit is 1 for this cache line. Now CPU going to line number 01 and getting that element and submitting to the comparator. So comparator is giving an element 1 to the comparator. This MUX is giving bit 1 to the comparator. The tag bit is 0. So comparator is checking 0, 1. If they are equal, it will give 1. If they are not equal, it will give 0. So they are not equal. So we are getting 0. So there is a caching miss. Okay. So what is the delay, total delay? So in order to hit latency, in order to find whether the cache hit or miss, what is the delay? Let us say MUX taking 1 nanosecond, comparator is taking 2 nanoseconds. Then total delay is equal to 1 nanosecond plus 2 nanosecond, 3 nanoseconds total delay. In order to find the hit latency is 3 nanoseconds. I told you, right? MUX can transfer only one bit. MUX contains, if the tag bits are 2 bits, for example, 2 bits, 0, 0, 2 bits. Then, so how to implement them? Then use another MUX. Okay. This is also 1 to 4. This is also 1 to 4 MUX. So connect every part parallelly. Okay. So we are getting input. Okay. So when our CPU generates an address 01, so we want to check 2 bits right now. So then we are using 2 MUX parallelly and getting elements. We have 2 elements. It is 01, right? CPU generating, CPU saying go to line number 1. Now MUX is going to at a time. Parallelly both MUXs are parallelly going 01 and getting 10 bit. Let us say this MUX is getting 1 and this MUX is giving to comparator 0 bit, 10. Now tag is tag at a time can check 2 bits at a time. This is a one comparator, this is nothing but 2 bit comparator. Now we are checking 00 with 10. They are not equal, right? It will give you cache miss. Okay, you got my point. So how they are getting the elements and giving, that is, you know, there's some device is there, they are getting. But right off now, you have to remember only one thing. Whenever we are giving line number 2 MUX, it will going to the cache and getting an element, going to the particular line in cache and getting the tag bit and submitting to the comparator. If one bit is, we can use only one MUX. If there are two tag bits, then we have to use 2 MUX, because MUX can only transfer 1 bit. Okay. If we have k tag bits, then how many MUX we have to use? K MUX we have to use. But comparator is 1 k bit comparator is enough. Okay. Now another, let us say so go to line number 00 and tag bit contains 10. This is also one. Let's just take